September 30th, 2024, Hartford, Connecticut. Visiting the graveyard was spooky. Approaching the Civic Center, which I called the XE, now they don't call it the Civic Center anymore.
Abandoned to me. I've never seen this closed down. So we're heading to the Bushnell Park. I have memories, a lot of memories of downtown Hartford. I remember I went to a restaurant and Marucha stole a fur coat out of the restaurant. Oh my God. I didn't know what to do. These look abandoned. I don't understand why this looks closed down. I have never, ever seen this closed down like that. All the way down. All the way down. And this era right here is always like a step in time. I've also never seen this part of downtown Hartford so abandoned, facing the Bushnell Park. But right behind me, these buildings right here are vacant. They look very abandoned. I have never seen this. We lived right over that tall building over there. We live right about behind that. So like someone said, downtown was our playground. It's just like a step in time. Very pretty. Like a little village. And as we go further up, on the left side is that old cemetery ground. People were buried in there in the 1600s. I'll go over there later for that red door. It's all vacant. Used to be a lot of discos down there. A lot of discos.
Of course, Tony Yards has been torn down.
We're heading toward the Bushnell, where I got sweet memories of falling into the pond when I was 8 years old. You know, there were no lights in the park back then in the 60s. That was the late 60s. We were heading to Park Street. A step in time back there. There's the graveyards right there where the gold building is, my favorite building. That went up in the 70s. Every teenager loved walking by that because you can see yourself. It was like a big old mirror. We're approaching the Bushnell Carousel. It's beautiful in there. The music's authentic, from pipe music, organ music from back in the day. I really love it there.
The old Bushnell. There's the pond. Used to be goldfish in there. They don't have fish in there no more. I used to go there with my mom and my two daughters, and we would feed the pigeons.
I have videos of that.
wrong and you want to do it, so I'll give them what happened.
Carousels, real wood horses and everything inside there. Oh, how I wish I could ride that. But I was on it once when it first was built here. They let me inside one time so I can videotape, and I love the music, like old carnival music. It's closed. When I was a little girl, I dreamed I was in those towers. A lady who does documenting of Hartford asked me if I wanted to go inside.
But I told her I was in an electric wheelchair, that I couldn't get up the stairs.
But how awesome. I couldn't thank her enough for that invite.
get inside the graveyard, but next time I go, I'll bring the drone and see what I can do there. I need some kind of lift to get up the stairs. Not these, but the ones in front on Main Street. It's a very old cemetery. And the tombstones are so beautiful.
I just came out of Harvey and Lewis. I had an eye exam, and so they put these glasses on because they gave me drops. And my eyes were so blurry. Graveyard's open, but there's a step and I can't get in the wheelchair. So I go around to investigate. I have a friend, Michelle. She has ancestors buried in this graveyard. She had asked me to videotape for her one time back in 2018. So I posted on Facebook. doing? Probably because it's done charging.
Okay, but the power light is on red. It stays steady. But the charging light used to be steady on red, but
and then
I
it
put
blinks.
It in the garage, now it's blinking.
Oh, okay. It probably because it's charged.
But when I press it,
but that's what mine does. But it don't work.
Nah, it don't come on.
Yeah, these chairs are pretty sketchy.
But if that power light...
The batteries don't last long. You probably have to replace the battery.
I read up. They said that, but they... Oh, my God. Okay, but I'm sorry to stop you.
Okay.
I had to ask somebody.
It's all right.
She haven't used it quite yet.
Yeah, you know? You have to use it, otherwise the battery dies.
You have to use it.
Yeah.
Wait.
But you have to... If you wait every...
You have to charge it whether you use it or not.
Yeah. It said keep charging every week.
Yeah.
Okay, but if the power light comes on red, is there a chance the batteries...
You're out of luck. You got to buy a new battery.
Okay.
The insurance company pays for it.
Okay, thank you, honey. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay.
By as a teenager to see myself. Bell bottoms and platform shoes.
Wait.
We're coming up to the old state house. Ghost hunters were here. Right here in this spot, this courtyard, the first witch was hung before Salem, Hartford, Connecticut, right in this spot right here, which is pretty weird and eerie. I used to walk by here all the time as a teenager. Used to be trolley station right here by the side. Of course, that's all. That road is gone. Used to be a street here. And it's all gone now. And the trolley center's gone. J.J. Newberry's is gone. The movie theaters are gone. All the shoe stores are gone. I think the only thing authentic still is this building right here to the left. But here it is, the old state house, which is haunted. They should really bring back decorating downtown Hartford for Christmas. It hasn't been the same since the late 80s, early 90s. They just don't decorate it for Christmas anymore. My childhood friend Dee Dee's father, Ralph, he used to put all the decorations on the poles going down the street. He did that. Coming home, Autumn.
Wait.